If you experimented with the frames per second demo, you may have noticed something odd. If you slid the slider from 30 frames per second up to 59 frames per second, the frame rate shown in the upper left was a pretty solid 32 milliseconds per frame. If you went all the way to 60 frames per second, this drops to 16 or 17 milliseconds per frame. This happens because a new frame is not computed until the previous frame is displayed. For example, say an image takes 12 milliseconds to compute. This is well within the 16.6 milliseconds per frame, so each frame will display a new image. If the image takes, say, 21 milliseconds, this is longer than the 60 frames per second rate. It's sort of like trains leaving the station at a constant rate. If you don't get your work done in time to catch the current frame, you have to wait until the next one comes around. The fastest we can display frames is 60 frames per second. So as soon as an image takes more than 1/60th of a second to compute, it will miss the first frame. This makes the effective frame rate 30 frames per second, since only every other frame is updated with a new image. I should say this doesn't always happen with every application. It depends on the way updates are done. This problem assumes that we don't begin to compute a new frame until an old one is displayed. The question to you then is, what is the effective frame rate if you just miss 30 frames per second? In other words, say your image compute time is a tiny bit greater than 1/30th of a second. At what rate can you display these images?